Hi, I'm Tim.
And I'm Lachlan, and we play in the Griswolds. Two of us met. We used to live across the road from each other, and sort of started playing in bands ages ago, and then finally got together with Chris and Dan, the other two, and yeah.
Sydney's pretty small, so we just played in bands and weren't going that well. Kind of didn't have the same aspirations, I guess, and yeah, we all got together, and now we're in Washington, D.C.
We're in the big city.
In the big city, the big smoke.
Washington D.C., City of Lights.
City of Lights.
Is the Garden State.
Or, nation's crossroads.
Nation's. We don't know what.
Yeah,
the,
we don't know what
the thing is, but we like to make them up.
Yeah. Whew, I'd say.
I'd like to say fun.
Fun?
Not the band fun, but.
No. Yeah. Yeah. They made it hard for us, didn't they?
They really did.
They did. Just kind of indie pop with a little bit of sunshine, a little bit of
this stuff.
Yeah. Sometimes I say rock. If someone asks me, like, just it's kind of a generic answer.
If a grandparent asks you.
If your grandparent asks you, you can't say indie pop because they don't know what that is. So.
You say, I play rock music.
I play rock music, yeah.
Like the Buddy Holly.
The Buddy Holly.
Yeah.
And the Beatles.
The artists that have influenced us, they're all like pretty eclectic, I think. Kanye West is a big one, obviously the Beatles, because we're all huge Beatles fans.
We all grew up on grunge music, I guess, was a big thing. Right. And then we progressed into Metallica and all that metal. And then we started,
obviously.
And then we started listening to some hip hop, and obviously we hear Vampire Weekend a fair bit.
Yeah, I guess like bands in our time bracket, like Phoenix are a really good one for us to look up to because, I don't know, they got the sh**.
Yeah.
they're the classiest live band as well, so they're
so
really
just
good.
Take all those influences and try and do something that sounds like us, I guess. Want people to come and obviously if they like the songs they hear on the record, but see it with energy, I guess, and a room full of people who also know those songs. That's an amazing feeling. Like,
yeah,
I guess.
I guess we probably put a bit more energy into the live set than the album, just because you know we're excited to be up there.
Yeah.
But then when the crowd sort of give you that energy as well, you just kind of feed off each other and this weird crazy thing happens and yeah, it's. Fun, loud, colourful.
Just want them to dance and sweat and cry. It'd be nice if they cried, got emotional.
That would be good.
That would be good.
That's when you know you've done a good set, like it's your Prince or something, and you've got the audience weeping.
They're just weeping. That's our goal. We want to make people cry.
My first concert I ever went to was an Australian band called Silverchair. So I don't know how big they were. In the States.
They had their time. They're not together anymore, but they are, they're kind of a staple for Australian teenagers, I guess.
So. That was my first.
Yeah. I'm going to say Silverchair 2 was my big first concert. I saw a bunch of smaller bands, but Silverchair was definitely that playing a venue more than 50 people there.
Yeah. Thank you so much, what's it time?